Hello everyone, in today's video, I'm going to be checking out On Hong Saigon, which is a popular restaurant specializing in authentic Vietnamese beef dishes. A couple of friends recommended that I try out this restaurant since it is their favorite restaurant and they've been going there for over 30 years and they've been going as often as once a week. They are both big foodies, so I'm curious to see what has kept them going back there for 30 years straight, so let's go. I just made it here to the restaurant and I ordered a variety of food. I got an appetizer and I also got some various grilled meats, so let's just get right into it. The first item I'm gonna start off with is an appetizer. It's the bánh xiao, which is almost like a Vietnamese egg crepe, and it's very thin, and the way you eat it is just by wrapping it up with some lettuce and some various Vietnamese herbs. I'll start by just cutting some of this thin egg crepe, and it feels really nice and light and crispy. Now I'm just gonna add a little bit of herbs to this as well before we wrap it up. Now we're just gonna go ahead and wrap this up and fold it into a small bite to eat. And finally, we're just gonna give it a little dip in our sauce that comes on the side. Here we go. This is really nice and fresh. It's still nice and warm. Oh, this is great. I love the mixture of hot and cold because you have the hot crepe on the inside. It almost reminds me of the egg roll in a sense because it's like a very thin egg crispy wrapper. And then inside of that, you have some pork as well, some vermicelli noodles. And on the outside, you have the crunchy and crisp lettuce leaf. And you just dip it in a little bit of sauce to add that savory flavor. And another really key important ingredient in this is all the different herbs. I just add a little bit of basil as well as some mint in here, which really adds just a unique fragrance. The next one I'm gonna try is the steamed beef patty. This already feels really interesting. It's really light and almost fluffy. And it looks like there's some vermicelli noodles and some Whittier mushrooms in here. Oh wow, this is masterfully made. I love how it's mixed with a little bit of egg because it really gives it almost like a light and fluffy texture. In a way, it almost reminds me of like a meringue. And then mixed in there, you got the Whittier mushrooms. I love that. And then you have a little bit of the vermicelli noodles. And what's really interesting is there's also a little bit of black pepper, which can add some fragrance to this. Now I'll be getting some of this rice paper for some of the meats. And for this, we're gonna have to dip it in some hot water first just to hydrate it. And if we just go like this, all we need to do is just give it a light dip in the water, and then we'll set this on our plate. In just a couple of minutes, this will be ready and edible to eat. We'll just start by placing some lettuce in the center of this wrapper. Now we'll get some fresh veggies. There's some cucumber. We'll add that in. And then we'll also get a few bean sprouts as well and add that in. And then we also have some pickled carrots as well as pickled radish. We'll also just get a little bit of these rice vermicelli noodles and we'll add that in as well. Wow. We'll also get some more herbs for this dish. We have this purple herb right here. We also have this green herb right here. It has a really unique, almost oceany umami scent. Of course, we can't leave out some mint either. And now I'm gonna put this beef sausage in the middle. And now that this is all ready, we can just wrap this up and roll it up. And of course, we gotta dip in our sauce on the side as well. This looks incredible. I'm already looking forward to this, because the beef sausage just looks tantalizing. Oh, I really love this beef sausage. It just tastes freshly made. It doesn't taste like it's been processed or anything. It just tastes like their own signature sausage blend. And it's very juicy. But what makes this really special is just the way it's eaten with all the different herbs. I mean, a lot of them have some really unique flavors, especially that one that sort of tastes like the ocean. It just adds this really unique, almost umami, like ocean salty like flavor. But it's not too overpowering just when you add a leaf. And then along with that, I love the pickled vegetables because they really added some nice nice and needed acidity to this dish. And then the perfect outer wrapper is really nice because I really love that texture of the chewy rice wrapper. Now I'm gonna try the lemongrass beef in my wrap, and I'm really curious about this one. Now that I've added all my herbs and vegetables, I'm just gonna go ahead and roll this up. I'm really looking forward to this because I love lemongrass, especially when it's mixed with some sort of meat dish. Oh, this is fantastic. It just keeps getting better and better. What's really interesting about this one is the lemongrass beef. It's like wrapped up in a roll. It's like thin slices of beef, and then it's rolled up, and it's filled with crunchy onions in the middle. And I love the lemongrass flavor. This has got that really unique, almost citrusy like taste, and that goes great, especially with the acidity of the pickled vegetables in here and the rice wrap. And again, the best part about it is all those unique herbs. Finally, I'm gonna try out our last grilled meat, which is the balalo, which is beef that is wrapped up in a leaf. Now that I've got this assembled, let's try out our final wrap. Well, this one is nice as well. And what I love about this one is the meat is a lot more gently flavored. It really lets you taste all the freshness of all the ingredients. Whereas the beef itself is just kind of like a plain beef, and it's wrapped in that leaf, which just has like a crispy and almost charred sort of taste since it's been grilled. And I just really love how everything goes together with all this, because it's not like an overly meaty dish since you have all the veggies in here and a rice wrapper. So this is really nice balance if you want something just a little bit less powerfully flavored. That was a fantastic meal. It was my first time trying Vietnamese food in this sort of style with all the different wraps, and I love the taste of all these different herbs. Many of them I haven't even tried before. Y'all should definitely try this out if you've never had Vietnamese food before. I think you're really gonna love this unique style of where it's really hands-on and you assemble your own food, and you're really gonna love your meal here. Anyways, I really hope you all enjoyed the video. Make sure if you did to give it a like, and also make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.